Okay, welcome back to the Caribou Data Science Channel. This is the afternoon of Friday, the 13th. Good news is my Hebrew class started last night. Okay. The more good news is that we're getting ready to work on we're going to use Quadro to create the final report. Okay, the final report. And in order to use Quadro, you have to install Quadro. Okay, let's read this. Then we'll come over here. Well, the first thing we have to do is. You have to come down here. Okay, so this is important here. So that's the first thing you got. You've also got plain text, okay? Let's go back over here. So you sort of begin with something like this. So this simply says the format is HTML and the code is true. Let's come back over here now. Check something out here. Echo false. Okay. hopefully this will turn off the code being displayed. Alright. Let's just try something. Let's see if this echo function actually works here. So let's try this. Very nice. So definitely turn. Now the question: do we have to put this in every single code chunk, or is it enough to do it in one? Okay, so that does appear that it didn't put out the okie dokie. Let's come back over here then. And we'll just keep this over here. Thank you. Okay, so now we come to our first point. Let's make this a little smaller. Actually, a lot smaller, 5 and 3. Now, does this have a description? No, it doesn't. Does this have a description? Okay. Let's run this. Now, I'm not going to run the entire, create the entire report here. Well, I'm just going to use the different chunks to show you how to do different things. You saw I could use the hashtags to do a title. You could do a plain text. You can also probably use the So that's interesting. Let's add one more plot here. Now this is where we get interesting. Now we're going to come over here. Let's try this. Okay. What we're going to do, try to add a caption. Okay. Fig. Okay. Fig cap. With any luck, this will actually place a caption below the screen, below the plot. Now you notice I put this part separate because of the caption. That may not actually be necessary. I could simply maybe put it underneath the show here and it automatically flows down, but we'll see what happens. Now, what this again, this is caption, so therefore I should display this caption underneath the plot if all goes well. I also need to change the size of this plot. And there's our caption. Okay? Let's come back over here now. So technically it'd be 7.5, but let's try 7. Let's run this again. See how this looks this time. That's good. Well, not quite. Oh shoot, let's make this one 10. Okay, and as you can see, we can also go back in and, you know, and tweak the plot sizes. See, this down here is part of the plot up there. Oh, I need to do this a little bit more, I guess. But you know what? You get the point. So there's three plots, there's three parts to this thing. You got sort of the header somewhere, the YAML up there, which is simply the it includes the title, it could also include author, it can probably include the date. Then you got code chunks. And this first line right here is very important. This says turn off the echo, so the code would not be echoed at that point. okay? Then from that point on, it's just code chunks, okay, code chunks. And the important thing here is that, and this last one here is that we included this function call right here, which gives us the, which gave us the caption underneath the plot, okay? That's all there is to it. Text, YAMLs, text, and code chunks, along with the echo false and the fig dash cap for what? For captions underneath the visualizations, okay? So I hope you find this very brief introduction to Quattro here. There's a lot more you can do with that. You can look on YouTube. You can look on YouTube, you find out there's one video out there has how to use Quattro to create a blog and use blog entries, among other things. But anyway, Quattro is the advantage of Quattro is, of course, that it works on both R and Python. It works in Jupyter Notebooks and RStudio. It works in VS Code, as you see here. So anyway, that takes care of that. So I hope you found this little brief intro helpful. Questions, comments, suggestions for future content. As always, welcome in the description below.